all I wanted to hear, right? That's all I was looking for. Does this shirt make me look fat? Come on.
Well, welcome to another installment of the Coffee House Concert Series. Thanks for tuning in to Milford TV. I'm Ray Osier, your host tonight. Every month, we have this great showcase featuring some local musicians playing their original music. And let's introduce them. We've got Ken Barney, his second time on the Coffee House Concert Series. Ken's here. Hi, Ken. How are you?
I'm great, Ray.
Good. Stephanie Irwin and Shawn Sennett, ladies and gentlemen. And Kev Dagle, who I understand is playing some original music for almost the first time, huh? Kind of?
First time publicly, yeah.
Publicly, nice. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to leave it to these fine folks. Kev's going to start things off. Enjoy this edition of the concert, Coffee House Concert Series. Thank you.
Well, my name's Kev Dagle. I actually play in a local cover band, but years ago I did do a bunch of original music and kind of shelved it for a little while, but had this great opportunity to come on Milford TV and play some songs. And this is actually kind of a rock tune that I used to do in an old band. I've kind of reconfigured it acoustically, and it's called Home Again.
Change your life today, leave you just the way you are, except the hurt will be far away. You went through hell, now I know the truth, but you never showed it on your face. If I can't help it, I'll bring you to a better place. I hate to see you destroy yourself over something you can't control. If there is justice, time will tell. Yeah. No, I show you that I care, but someday I'll take you there. Take you home again. You need a change of scenery to the way you used to be. I'll take you home again. Change scenery to where you
That's it. Thank you.
All right, I'm Shawn Sennett. This is Stephanie.
Hello.
We got together a couple months ago. Well, we got together about a year ago. We started practicing. And it didn't last that long. We were planning on playing out some bars, but we got back together. And we've only been practicing, what, we had like four practices? And we wrote two songs, and that's what we're going to play. And I'm going to play two songs that I wrote. But we're going to start with one of the ones we did. And she basically started it, and I added a chorus, and we pretty much just went from there. And this is it. And it's called Over Now.
Ken Barney. Thanks for having me back here again. Is that all right? Sound fine? All right, good. I'm going to do a song here that I wrote many years ago. My wife and I used to kind of live like gypsies for a while. We lived in Steamboat Springs, Colorado, where I played during ski seasons, and then we would move back to Cape Cod and live in the beach towns and do this, and we were happy doing that, but we kind of one night had that biological clock conversation and decided maybe we should make a plan, do one more year out in Colorado and see where that takes us. So we had that plan. We were going to finish up with one more ski season, stay out there for the summer, finish one more ski season, then come back home and maybe grow up a little bit and do the family thing. And as the time was getting nearer, I wrote this leading up to the final couple of months. It's kind of an inner dialogue struggle of, do I really want to do this? And I did, but it's where the song was kind of born from, so. Ain't it something in the morning, the way the sunrise greets us as it crawls over the mountain, and we all start our day. And I remember you once told me, anywhere can be our home as long as we're together. Now that chills me to the bone as we begin to think that maybe now it's time we settle down back east and start that family and leave this tourist town. Though I believe when we're together, that's where our home may be. I've just been doing this so long, I'm so afraid to lose my dreams. Something in your eyes tells me everything will be alright. If I could just open up and break down these walls I've built inside so many years ago. Why did I build them? I don't know. Was it to keep me safe within or for the benefit of the others looking in? We begin to think it's time to settle down. This great world still accept me once I cease to play the clown. Though I believe when we're together, that's where our home may be. I've just been doing this so long, so afraid of losing me. Last night I sat on the great divide. Meteor showers filled Colorado skies. Last night I watched the stars disappear and I felt the calm serenity wash over me and my fear. Ain't it something in the evening, the way the sunset waves goodbye and falls off of the river, and darkness fills the sky. The stars now take their places on this clear September night. Is it me or do they somehow burn a little brighter as we begin to think that maybe now it's time we settle down and back east and start that family and leave these tourist towns. I believe when we're together, that's where our home may be. I've been doing this so long, loving you is all I need. All I need is you. Thanks. Thank you, guys.
So this next song that I have is, again, kind of from my past when I was in an original rock band. It's actually really not all that much rewritten. It's just, instead of electrified, it's acoustified. So it's basically the good feelings you get when you're in love. And it's called End of Time.
I never thought I'd find someone who'd make me feel like you do. You stepped into my life in my time of need. I just need you all the time.
Same thing here. We got the next song. She started it. I finished it.
Waves of black and white, barely in the gray. Make it through tonight, just for one more day, one more day. Whoa. Flooding the night, gotta build a boat of hope somehow. Waves of black and white, barely in the gray. Make it through tonight, just for one more day, one more day.
Oh, while I've been thinking, my ship's been sinking down. I figured it out. There's no tomorrow. I gotta live for now. There's no way out. My ship's been sinking.
Progress, people.
All mine are. So, all right. So I'm gonna get. Jeez, I've never played this song out. And I think it has a long story to it, and I'm gonna try not to bore you all with it, but I don't know how else to explain it without telling you all the different layers that I think went into this. Oftentimes, when I write a song, I know exactly what I want to say, and it comes out. Every now and then, I surprise myself when I listen back to it and think, what was I thinking, you know, and how did it come out? So I will tell the story behind this song. So, a few years ago, a fellow musician, Bill McGoldrick, came to see me and started hanging out a little bit and said, I like your original songs, you should record those. My friend John Freitas has a studio. So I was very nice and great, but I don't know John Freitas. So Bill kept saying that, geez, you should really record with my friend John Freitas. So, lo and behold, at the same time in my life, I kind of felt like I'm not really a deeply spiritual or religious man, but kind of felt like raising my family and kind of working like a dog, there's something else that maybe I need to reach for to have a little help from time to time. So that was going on in my mind, and I was kind of searching a little bit, but one night had a Saturday night off, so I went to see Bill and Pam Stiebler play. So lo and behold, I belly up to the bar, and this gentleman and I strike up a conversation, and sure enough, he says, "Hi, I'm John Freitas." So as we're talking, and this is kind of funny, on the way up there, I was listening to the Eagles' Unplugged Heart of the Matter, and I just thought, this song is awesome. The harmonies coming in and everything. So as John and I began talking, he said, out of the blue, he was like, "You know what? You should come to my church tomorrow morning. I'm in a kick-ass band. We're opening up with Heart of the Matter." I had one of those, "Yeah, if I could just see a sign somewhere along the way." So John and I became fast friends, and we did begin recording together and played a two-piece band quite a bit. He played a saxophone and flute and harmonicas. Now, this is not supposed to be a sad song. Unfortunately, John died very unexpectedly last year. So I was kind of in a really bad place for a little while. And about a month later, when I kind of cleared my head a little bit and tried to get my hands wrapped around it, I wrote this song. So it's more intended to be written towards him, for him, but I'm not sure exactly that's where it stayed the whole time. And it really isn't a sad. It was kind of about redemption and that feeling of coming back out of the little abyss that I seem to be sitting in for a while, so. Well, I see things less cheery now through my tears and sighs. Life would come in much more clearly now if I could see it through his eyes. Strength I call on deep within, I'm not sure I possess. Must I discover it now at the expense of a friend, like some kind of twisted test? I'm not alone, I know. I heard the preacher tell me so. But oh, my heart does ache. I'm afraid it just might break. I'm not alone, I see. I'm just a branch upon his tree. But oh, my heart does ache. I'm afraid it just might break. And in my selfish way, I weep for me. In my selfish way, I embrace the pain. In my selfish way, I refuse to see what the greater cause in this might be. I'm beginning to see things more cheery now, not accepting why. When at the heart of the matter, it's just you and I still ignore the signs. I'm not alone, I know. I heard the preacher tell me so. But oh, my heart does ache. I'm afraid it just might break. Just a branch upon his tree. Oh, my heart still aches. I've taken all that I can take. And in my selfish way, I weep for me. In my selfish way, I embrace the pain. In my selfish way,
causing this might be. Selfish ways I'd weep for me. In my selfish ways I'd embrace the pain. In my unselfish way I begin to see what the greater cause in this might be. In my selfish ways for me, in my unselfish way, I release the pain. In my unselfish way, I begin to see what the greater cause in this might be.
All right, so this next song I wrote, it was actually written for my oldest daughter, Carrie, when she hit a milestone. She turned 18, so it's basically just a song kind of lamenting the fact that, you know, maybe I could have done some things better for her, but just to let her know that, you know, she was still special.
Backwards I can't go. It's been a long, long road. I wasn't always there. I wish that I'd been there. But now you've made it through. You're stronger than I knew. Such a long, long road. But you became the one I'd always hoped you'd be. A leap of faith it took for me to let you be. You can face into your fears, you know they will go away. You became the one. they will go away. I'll be here for you. Here for you. Here for you. Thank you.
All right, so this next song I'm gonna do, I wrote kind of about my upbringing, childhood. Kind of goes back to my father not really being there, growing up in a rough neighborhood, the late 80s, early 90s. 12 years old, fist fights, that whole thing, and what it does to you mentally and how, you know, it can make you stronger. It's called Give 'Em Hell. And here we go. Told me it'd be a long road, but they never pointed me the right way. I just needed some encouragement, yeah, baby. I needed someone to say, hey.
This song is, I tend to think that I'm very open and I can communicate with anyone all the time. And I realize now as I'm getting older, oftentimes those communications don't really get put out the way they should. They get written down in a song late at night. And I kind of feel great about it because I've got my release. I've said something that was important to get off my chest. Unfortunately, somebody on the other end of the line never quite heard it. So I can remember how to play this. So I wrote this song. It's called Words Upon My Sleeve. And it kind of speaks of the adage that we're all taught, that actions speak louder than words. So one night as I was thinking about it, I said, I had that epiphany. Sometimes words have to be spoken in order to get those thoughts out there, and you can't just always assume people know, so I wrote this song. His mind. I tend to keep things bottled up inside till late at night with no one else around. That's when I find my walls come tumbling down, and those words flow so freely from my lips. The music passes through my fingertips, and I wonder if she'd still be here with me if I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve. If I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve, she might have known how much she means to me. Perhaps our actions really aren't that loud, and it's the words that matter after all. And I wonder if she'd still be here with me if I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve. My boy is growing up so fast. There's so much that I don't say, so much I fail to ask. She told me, sometimes you've got to dig. And remember, he's only just a kid. But those words flow so freely from his mouth. If I could find a way to drag them out and discover what those baby blue eyes see, if he could wear his words upon his sleeve, if I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve, she might have known how much she means to me. Perhaps our actions really aren't that loud, and it's the words that matter after all. I wonder if she'd still be here with me if I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve. Something stupid years ago to someone that I love. I was too young and dumb to know. For all these years I've longed to make it right. Now I find myself alone here late tonight, and those words flow so freely from my lips. The music pours out of my fingertips. He's always been there for me in my time of need, in spite of when I wore my words upon my sleeve. I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve, she might have known how much she means to me. Perhaps our actions really aren't that loud, and it's the words that matter after all. I wonder if she'd still be here with me if I'd have
worn my words upon my sleeve. If I'd have worn my words upon my sleeve, from now on I'll wear my words upon my sleeve.
Thanks. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Just gonna tune up a little bit. All right, so this last song I'm going to play, Ray was generous enough to allow me to come on here tonight to showcase some of my stuff, and I said, so what, two or three songs, and he said, four originals. And I went, ooh! So I got to work to bust out an original over the last week, and it's still pretty new. As a matter of fact, I had to put my glasses on so I can actually read the words. So it's called Days Will Come, and in a few words, it's basically about sitting back and hoping that opportunity comes knocking, and very rarely does that ever happen. So it's never too late to get off your butt and start going after what you want. Case in point, what I'm doing tonight. So.
Days will come, but the years will go. Putting up my dreams, time's gone before we know. It's always been, it never fades. Just one more chance before I'm on the grave. Help is nothing, so I'm told. Make excuses for the things that I withhold. And I say, enough waiting, enough waiting. You know it's up to me to get where I wanna be. No more wedding, blow the dust off my life, make my own destiny. Destiny. Myself away, afraid to be exposed, and I say, enough waiting, enough waiting. You know it's up to me to get where I wanna be. Enough waiting, no more waiting. Blow the dust off my life, make my own destiny.
Thanks.
Perfect.
Thanks for your patience.
All right, so this next song here, it's called Just a Dream. It's about making mistakes and paying for those mistakes. And it's in a relationship and actually getting forgiveness and, you know, waking up in the middle of the night and after a nightmare and just praying that it was just a dream, and thankfully it was. And the past is the past, and we move forward. So I wrote this for my fiance, and so here we go, just a dream.
Thank you.
She says she loves him like a brother. She could spend her life with him. She is proud to be the mother of four young children. And the days go passing by, she's still the apple of his eye, just as she has always been. He works his fingers to the bone. That's no more sacrifice any good man's ever known for the family he provides. And the days go flying past, the future slips into the past and writes the story of our lives. And the Joneses from next door are always so impressed. She knows that even more, her life is truly blessed. But in that place nobody knows, she keeps mainly for herself. These days more frequently she goes in search of something else, but the fire deep inside she no longer can deny screams to be let out. And the Joneses from next door are always so impressed. She knows it even more, her life is truly blessed, truly blessed. That rocking chair on the front porch every day, with a thought she just can't bear of when she is old and gray, with a man she loves just like a brother. She can't spend her life with him. More than just a mother, there's so much more within. Her heart is broken deep inside. She keeps up the facade as the flame is growing dim. Her heart is broken deep inside, but she keeps up the facade. The flame grows ever dim. Broken hearted deep inside, but she keeps up the facade while her flame grows ever dim. She says she loves him like a brother.
Thanks. Thank you, guys. Oh.
So, Ken, tell us where people can find your music.
Oh, geez, you can't. I'm in studio now, finally doing this long-awaited project of all original music. Other than that, you can find me on Facebook, Ken Barney. I play out pretty much every Thursday, Friday, Saturday night. Mostly covers, but I'm trying to do more originals, so I look forward to doing that. But you can find me on Facebook, Ken Barney. I'm the first person that pops up.
Sure. Shawn?
Yeah, you can find me on Facebook as well, Shawn Sennett, and on YouTube. Same thing, Shawn Sennett. Type in one of my songs. Type in Just a Dream. It will come up. And that was just one of the songs. There's about 9 or 10 other originals on there that you didn't hear tonight that are on YouTube. And if you wanted to purchase any of my music, you can contact me on Facebook. And I have CDs at my house, and that's about as far as I've gotten so far, so.
Thanks, Sean. Kev?
I am on Facebook. It's Kev Dagle, which is Dagle with no I, D-A-G-L-E. I do have some tunes on Reverb Nation, and the songs that I did tonight will be on YouTube as soon as you guys put it up on YouTube.
And give a plug for the band, too.
I'm actually the lead singer of Mass Octane. We're a local cover band specializing in 80s hair metal songs.
Watch previous episodes at youtube.com/mymilfordtv. And for more programming on Milford TV, go to milfordtv.net. Thank you very much to Rob and Justin behind the scenes running things. Thanks to Milford Performing Arts Center for letting us do the Coffee House Concert Series in their facility here at 150 Main Street in Milford. And thanks for watching, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you next time.